Hello, Windows Club. Michael with the Windows Club. Now, Windows 10 is an amazing platform. However, a common complaint is that Windows may not be fast enough. It sometimes takes too long to perform functions and may lag. In this video, we're going to look at ways to make Windows 10 faster. And as always, we will link an informative article in the description below that will go further into depth. Now, before we begin, two things. First, many of the tips we will go over can be done by a freeware app made by the Windows Club called the Ultimate Windows Tweaker. In it, you can adjust most any settings in Windows to enhance your performance and personalize it. There is a link in the article that will allow you to download it. And the other thing, before making any changes to your computer, it is always important to make a system restore point in case a change or changes creates an undesired result and you want to restore your computer to an earlier version. First, let's look at restricting the number of startups. The reasonable thought is, why have so many programs starting up when you sparingly use it? If you go to the search bar and type startup, you can look at which apps run at startup and decide if you want them to run. Then, let's look at removing Crapware from the system. Crapware is the pre-installed software that, while not bad, chokes up your hard drive with unnecessary software, takes up space, and overwhelmingly just slows down the system. There are several paid and free apps out there that can perform this admirably. And we offer links to several high-quality apps that you can look at and download the version that best works for you. Now, for our next one, you want to look up in the search bar for Fast Startup. Fast Startup is a great tool to use. The premise behind that is when you shut down your computer, it does not completely shut down. Some parts of the computer in a sort of hibernation mode when you're ready to go when you restart it. That means you should boot up faster. Now, by default, in a Windows 10 computer, it is enabled and you need to go into the power settings and disable it. Now, if you want to look at Fast Startup in your computer, what I do is look up, go into power and sleep settings. From there, go to additional power settings, choose what the power buttons do. Now, by default, in a Windows 10 computer, it is enabled and you need to disable it. Now, for a faster experience, like I said, leave it enabled. Now, if you want to go a little bit faster, you can change your visual effects. To do that is type in adjust the appearance and performance of Windows. This will open a dialog box. You can unselect options manually. Now, this will tweak the visual effects and remove a lot of the visual eye candy and give Windows 10 a sort of a bland look. You'll have to decide if that is worth the speed you might gain from it. While deleting junk and temporary files may not exactly make your Windows faster, it is a matter of good housekeeping. You can use the built-in disk cleanup utility or some freeware that's out there. In the end, the more that you optimize Windows, the better your machine will perform. The next question is energy efficiency or power? The default power setting saves you energy, but in the same sense, you'll lose about 50% of your CPU power in the Windows operating system. If you want a more powerful, faster computer, then go into power and sleep, additional power settings, and my suggestion is go high performance. Crank that bad boy up and let her go full throttle. Now, I'm guilty of this next one. A lot of people make the mistake of leaving their computers on all the time. If you restart your computer at least once a week, you'll improve speed exponentially as you will clear out its memory and ensure that any errant processes and services that started running are shut down. Now, SSDs, they're starting to become big. For faster speeds, an SSD can make your Windows 10 computer start, run, and start up faster. defragment your drives regularly. Now, these days are not like the days of Windows 95 or the Millennium Edition or 2000, where you had to manually defragment. The built-in Windows defragmenter does a good job of keeping up. You can go in and manually do it. Just type defragmenter, and analyze and optimize the drives. Now, you can also use a third-party defragmentation software as well if you think that maybe you can get a little bit better out of it on third-party. From time to time, it's a good idea to run the check disk to make sure that the hard drive is functioning properly. In Windows 10, Microsoft has redesigned check disks to run automatically to check for file system errors, bad sectors, lost clusters, things like that. But you can type in check disk and run it whenever you have a fancy. Just to be sure that it's also good tip, if you're facing errors in your computer that might be the result of a disk error. Depending on the usage of your computer, you can configure the process scheduling so that it gives you the best performance. To do this, open a run box and type in sysdm.cpl. Then, under the Advanced tab, under Performance, go to Settings. In Settings, click the Settings buttons and you'll see two settings. Adjust for best performance, adjust for best appearance, or let Windows choose what's best for your computer. If you want, of course, better appearance, then you would click the first one. If you want better performance, then you could click the second. Or you could just leave it at its default setting of letting Windows choose what's best for your computer. If you decide to change it, hit apply, hit OK. Then, let's look to ensure that boot defragmentation is enabled so that files used during startup are grouped together. Now, to do this, we need to open the registry editor. Once you have the registry set, go to H key, local machine, software, Microsoft, DFRG, boot optimization. You want to select enable, right click on it, select modify, and if it isn't already have the value set to Y, then set it to Y, click OK, then restart your computer. Another tip, during the boot time, enter the BIOS settings by pressing the delete key during boot up, and disable seek floppy disk drive. This is a time saver for those who don't use floppy disk. Now, there are some biohacks like enabling quick post, disabling boot delay, and the such, but believe me, it's best to refrain from using these. While we're on the subject of BIOS, let's look at changing the boot order sequence. In normal settings, the boot sequence is set to floppy first, then CD, then hard disk. By changing that order to hard disk first, then CD and floppy, you could potentially save a few seconds in the startup. Another way to save a few seconds is disable the screensaver if you don't need it. Type in screensaver into the search bar, dialog box opens up, set it to none, click apply, click OK. Fonts can take time to load. Removing some can save on resources, but be careful in deciding which fonts to remove. If you delete some system fonts, you might be in for some trouble. If you want to shave off some time off of the shutdown, open the registry editor again. Go to H key, local machine, system, current control set, and control. You're looking for wait to kill service timeout. Right click on it and go to modify. As you can see, the default is set to 20,000. Setting it to a lower four-digit value will make it shut down faster. But you potentially could lose data or cause a disk corruption, so use this one with caution. But remember one thing. In setting that new value, Windows doesn't recognize a three-digit number, so be careful. Uninstall programs that you no longer use, games, Zoom, other programs that you've not used in some time and might not ever use again, or rarely, consider uninstalling it. Myself, when it comes to games, if it's a Steam game, I uninstall it until I'm going to play it again, since I know it's safely stored there. Other tweaks you can do to reduce storage space and increase potential speed is to save documents and files onto a cloud storage and not your PC. This also has the added benefit to make it accessible from any computer and protects files from loss in the event of corruption on your computer. And like I said in the beginning of our video, if you get the ultimate Windows tweaker, most of everything that we talked about in this video can easily be done, and much more from the Ultimate Windows Tweaker. Do you have other tips to make your Windows 10 computer run faster? Did you try any of these? Let us know in the comments below. For more tips on getting the most on your Windows device, visit us at thewindowsclub.com. This video helped you? Then give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our page, where we are always uploading new content aimed at making your digital life a little easier. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.